mate. All right, over to you guys.
Thanks, mate.
Well, the crew is just getting sorted with the cameras there. We don't want to miss 1 second of this trip. We're heading out to Channel Country in outback Australia. Then we're going to turn right and see how close we can get to the top of Australia. I've always wanted to see just how beautiful and diverse this beautiful country of ours actually is, and to see it from a small aeroplane, the classic Cessna 172, it's going to be remarkable. This is Out and Back 2.
Yeah, done a bit of a long range forecast for our trip and it's looking pretty good.
No, well, the crew's in its final stages of planning. Everything's going like clockwork. All the weight and balances have been done, the weather's looking fantastic. An engineer has checked the aircraft, flight plans have been lodged, and we are getting so, so close. And you know what? It looks like we are going to get all the way to Horn Island, right to the top of Australia. We'll be travelling more than 3,000 nautical miles, and between the ever-changing landscape and incredible sunsets, we'll seek out some of the characters that truly make up the backbone of rural aviation. And we'll give you plenty of tips and advice along the way, and some extra information on our safety topics page. I'm flying with Catherine Fitzsimons in the Cessna. Catherine's a chief flying instructor from Bathurst who's experienced in teaching jackaroos how to fly and is used to covering endless miles in a light aircraft. Dan Murphy will be flying our support aircraft, the GA8 Airvan. The Airvan's suitably named as it carries a fair bit of gear, but Dan's already laid down the law. 7 kilos each, that's all. Catherine and Dan have refueled both planes and done their daily inspections, so I think we're ready to go. And I can't wait.
Wheels have just left the ground. This journey has started. We've just taken off from Bathurst and the conditions are really favourable.
Yep, very pleasant conditions. We've got some cloud that we'll need to stay below for the time being, but we can see the horizon clearly ahead, so we're good.
It's pretty spectacular. The visibility is so nice from up here at the moment.
Turn the track at 7,200 feet unverified. The other is slightly north of that track at 8,300 feet, unverified, tracking west, will be passing about 1 minute.
It's just interesting, and that's why it's good to listen to the area frequency. But he's alerted some aircraft to the fact that there were two of them quite close together south of Bathurst. This is in Class G airspace, where it's see and be seen, we all look after ourselves. So I'm always listening, as well as the frequency that I might be broadcasting on, I'm always listening on this other frequency just in case there's some information that will help me with situational awareness, and then I might need to make sure what I might need to broadcast there and say, hey, I might be one of those aircraft.
Always be on the right frequency at non-controlled aerodromes, and if there's an assigned frequency, well, that's the one you use. And if you don't have a designated frequency, always use 126.7. And for those that aren't on the charts, well, you always use the aerial frequency. Go to the CASA website for more info.